I am now requesting Professor Kannan to conduct his interaction with heads of the institutions, and immediately after he finishes, we will raise general issues which are of concern to the participating faculty. And in the end, I would request once again Professor Sahasrabuddhe to share some other initiatives which are very important for engineering institutions, which he told us during the tea break. And I thought it will be nice if you could tell all of us about these things at the concluding part. So Professor Kannan, all yours.
Welcome back. So one of the important sessions was to take feedback of the heads of institutions, which you have already given, but then it would require summarizing that and so on. So what I thought was I would take that feedback once again using a technology called Plickers. And then because this is actually useful in the classroom also. So what I have is I have cards like this. So this is going to be given to the heads of institutions. Each card has a number. So in theory, one can actually map the student's name or roll number to this. But in this case, it is not required. I don't need to know who's answering what question. But we just want to get a feedback. And I was told that there were 40 heads of institutions. So I've got a Plickers card made with 40 such things. Each one has a separate number. Depending on how you hold this, there are A, B, C, D. If the answer, your answer is A, you hold A above. If it is B, you take B. Then what I will do is I will scan it, collect it, and then we will display it on the screen. Okay? So I thought we will do this with the heads of institutions. This clicker methodology is one of the most proven educational technology developed interventions. So I'm going to, I have only 40. So we'll give this to the heads of institutions. Yeah. So if you just read that, there will be a number and also sites A, B, C, D. If your answer to the question is A, have the A above. And I'm going to scan this. Depending on the size of the class, one can also print it on a bigger one, like one picture for a whole page, which is what I should have done had I known that it would be held here. I thought I was going to do it in seminar number two. It's a smaller room, so there we could do two of these and then cut them, which is what we have done. So you have to make sure that you do this. What I will do is I will scan it using this, and the results will come.
Tell them how to hold each one for A, B, C, D.
Yeah. So, for example, this says A. And so, if your choice is A should be in the top.
A is written there.
Yeah, A is written there. Not from here, but this thing knows. Yeah.
A, B, C, D is written there.
And also, in this particular case, we are just taking a feedback. So there is nothing like one answer is correct. But in class, we can use it and say, what is the correct answer? And so this software is called Plickers, as you can see there. It actually allows you to, at the time of creation, you can say, this is the right question. And this clicker methodology is something proven. I will talk about it maybe after this feedback thing is over. So once you know, so I'm going to take answers from you for this. Hold your hold the card. If your card is captured, it'll appear on the screen. If your number appears, then you can put it down. If your number appears, see, every card has a number. If that appears on the screen, then you no longer have to hold it.
Yeah.
ಮಾಡೋದು. How to hold it up. Okay. All right. So we've got the graph. Okay, let's go to the next question. So typically what happens is, now that the way I conduct the class, I have used clickers extensively in my class. What I do is, if many people don't get the question correct, answer correct, I tell them, okay, talk to your neighbor. Talk to your neighbor. So the students talk to each other. There is a lot of commotion, a lot of noise. And then do this polling once again after a minute or so. And most of the time, the students get it, because they know which student actually knows the answer. Go and talk to them. And that student is able to convince, able to explain better, okay, many times. So you conduct the poll again, that is to find out whether they have understood. If they still don't understand, it is time for you to spend a couple of minutes, 5 minutes, to explain what is the correct answer and why.
So our that faculty colleagues will appreciate that this is nothing but a think, pair, share kind of thing being implemented. But you can all see, particularly the heads of the institutions, how powerful learning mechanism this approach could be. This is part of the active learning. And unfortunately, our teaching colleagues are not at all initiated into these things, simple things which can be done in a classroom.
Okay, let's do the next one. So we have 22 as remote centers, 17 are not remote centers. So let me go to the next one. So it's okay. Okay.
I just comment on this. Last time when Additional Secretary Mr. Subramanian was here, I had an informal talk with him about extending the NMEICT 10KT project. And he said they have returned to the Finance Ministry to permit extension without any additional sanction, and he hopes to get it. What I did is, he was addressing all our 300 staff members. So I announced publicly that the Additional Secretary has promised that the thing will be extended. In his talk, he said, Professor Phatak has an uncanny habit of getting commitments done on public forums. What Professor Kannan is doing, exactly the same thing.
He has learned from you.
Okay. So the initial few are, maybe all of you will say yes. But subsequently, we have some questions. For which you will give different answers. Okay. So this is fine. Okay, the next one is labs to conduct workshops interaction. So this one, Professor Phatak, because you had given tick more than one, that I could not ask in this. So I had to convert it into this. So shall we go ahead with conduct all of it, right? Because it'll take another few minutes.
Questionnaire had, you could tick multiple options, but he had to convert it because of the software, each one as an individual question.
By the way, this is what I was doing when sitting there, because I had gone to conduct a TechWeek course. I also came late last night, and maybe some of you thought that I was watching cricket. Okay, I was actually creating this questionnaire, putting it in this thing called clickers. Okay. So this is lesser academic load. So one of the problems is possibly because this is a flexible kind of a thing.
I didn't have time to mount it on a cardboard. If it is mounted on the cardboard, then it will come flat. And it picks up a lot more easily. Here, some of you are probably not holding it straight. So as a result, it is probably not, it has difficulty picking it up. Okay. So this is the question. Some are unable to provide this, but majority of them are able to reduce the academic load. Okay, let's go to the next one. So now you have to choose. These are different answers. I'm going to give you some time. Please read that. Okay. So depending on your answer, it could be A, B, C, D. There is nothing like which is correct. So please select accordingly. Please, can you please show it towards this? So what it does is, in a class, it forces everybody to participate, every student to participate, to give an answer. Of course, we are asking for only one. It is possible that there is more than one. So select the best, the most optimal, okay? Or we have to ask in a different way. This also has to be split. But for the time being, we'll go ahead with this. So here is
this response is not different from many other heads of the institutions that I have talked to, including our own administration here. All administrators believe that any such noble work should be done by their faculty members only in their faculty members' free time and not the institution's time. This is vacation.
So you have to choose live view now. So I created a question in the library, assigned it to a question, then I'm asking live view. Okay, so you have to show only A or B, right? Of course, it is possible that you have, for some of you, both may be correct. I mean, both may be acceptable. Okay. So about equal. Okay.
So we just got a center established under Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya scheme. Ideally, you should have some infrastructure where the center could operate, but it is not necessary. For example, currently we don't have any physical infrastructure. But the faculty members who participate in the activities of the Teaching Learning Center will work together, typically revolving around the head of the center. So if head of the center, for example, in our case, Prof. Kannan is head of that center. Now, since he comes from the chemical engineering department, the head of the chemical engineering department will provide facility like a seminar hall or whatever to conduct this meeting. But he could go to any other department or to the institute to get facilities. So to begin with, you don't need to have infrastructure. But if you set this up as a long-term activity, then you must plan. That center should also conduct, in my opinion, other than such outreach programs, research on ETN educational pedagogy. So we traditionally don't have Department of Education in engineering institutions, but one is actually required now to incorporate all these things. So IIT Bombay has the ET activities, as I told you, Professor Sridhar Iyer now heads that, and has been there for quite some time. So this is in that context, actually. So all of you might want to think that if you have not planned it earlier, you may want to think about doing it.
That's okay, we just wanted to get a rough idea of what it is. So are there any questions? We did this, actually, I'm happy that it was done here because all faculty members also got to see it and it can be practiced. You can, at the time of creation, you have to tell what is the class size, 40, 70 or something like that. If it is, maximum it allows is 70, but then you can run two classes simultaneously. So it is actually possible to do this for larger class also. And this is highly recommended that you implement it, you understand whether the, because students in front of you nod. It's a nodding does not mean that they have understood. Very often it is a reflexive action. They think that they didn't nod. And it is a rude shock. I mean, I have had rude shocks many times, that after a month, they have not understood the basics. So what should I do? Go back and teach that again or go forward? Either way, I'm not going to finish the portion. Okay? So I think there is only one thing that is not done, their feedback which they have given.
Yeah,
I mean, textual feedback.
No, that's
Okay, thank you very much.